Hello internet, and welcome to my channel. First of all, Happy New Year. This video is being filmed on 1st of January. That means New Year's Day. And that means it's damn quiet on the road and a nice time to ride motorcycle. So what am I gonna talk about today? What are my plans for 2021? First of all, my channel is, I just started my channel, so I don't have that much subscribers, so I'm gonna try to get subscribers, of course. And also I'm gonna do a few things, or my goal is to do a few things. First thing is to start orienting for a new motorcycle or another motorcycle. Not a second, maybe a second, but then it has to be a kind of a project bike. But I'm gonna look for something else, and that something else is probably going to be a ADV motorcycle. Why? For someone who rides all year round, that's one of the most logical choices. To go get an ADV bike. Maybe if I don't enjoy an ADV bike, I don't get an ADV bike. Well, maybe if I don't enjoy it, then I won't get one. But in that case, I'm gonna look for something with a little more power. Like I said in my 10,000 kilometers review of my C800, I'm gonna look for something with a little more power than this one. Also, I'm gonna look for a motorcycle with a 6-speed gearbox. Why? Because I ride a lot of highway when I ride motorcycle, when I commute or whatever. And yeah, just feels a little less stressed. I rode 6-speeds before. I rode a Harley once with 6-speed. And my motorcycle was a 6-speed Yamaha naked bike. So these are the things I can compare it to. And what I just noticed is that even if you do catch a lot of wind on a naked bike, but it's still a little more relaxing when riding it on a highway than this one. So that's first, orienting on ADV bikes. And the other things are meeting more people, joined a Discord server for Dutch motorcyclists, and that's a really nice community. People are nice, people are helpful, but of course I don't know a lot of people. Well, honestly, I know only a few people, probably can count on one hand, who own a motorcycle, and there's only one I can ride with, and that's also occasionally because I'm the only one to ride a motorcycle all year long from the people I know. So that's one of the things I'm trying to do. Meeting new people and getting in touch with new people and just get a little network. People who ride motorcycles. Just also to do little rides. Not with a lot of people, like not with 10, 20, but just a ride with 3, 4, 5 other motorcyclists would be nice. Once in a while, of course. And then another goal for me is to do a lot more maintenance on my motorcycle myself, especially on this one. A few months ago, I changed my oil on this one. I changed the oil filter. Took me a while, about 4 hours, just to change the oil. That was pretty embarrassing, but that was because I couldn't get the oil filter any loose. So that's one of the things I'm going to try to do, a lot more maintenance on my own motorcycles. Or my own motorcycle, because I don't have multiple. And to get back to the what motorcycle would I get if I would get a kind of a project bike. It's not really a project bike. I'm not gonna turn a racer, a super sport, whatever you want to call it, into a cafe racer. No, I will keep the motorcycle just stock, but the main purpose for that is, like I just mentioned, doing maintenance myself. This is my daily ride. If I do something and this one can't move for 1, 2, 3 weeks, well, that's horrible because I can't get anywhere. Yeah, I can lend my girlfriend's car, but yeah, I just enjoy riding motorcycle much more. So that's why I wanna get a kind of a project bike, more maintenance bike. An older one. Yesterday someone advised me get an enduro cross motorcycle just to, yeah, because they're easy, one cylinder of course, and it's a lot easier to maintain them. Well, I can understand that because there's little to no electronics on it. But also here in the Netherlands, dual sports enduro motorcycles are pretty expensive. In other countries you see people who can buy them for 1,000 to 2,000 euros. Here most motorcycles, when it comes to 250 to 450 cc's, these motorcycles will cost about 3,000 to 4,000. And for a maintenance bike, just to do maintenance on, ride around a little, of course if I get something like an enduro bike, dual sport, cross motor, I will use it a lot more in this kind of weather, just to have a little more fun, or just to have a little more fun just to get on the dirt tracks and stuff. That's the reason why I would get a second motorcycle. In that case, I would not get rid of this one. I would just have two motorcycles, own two motorcycles, and yeah, do maintenance on one and have one just for daily rides. So these are my plans. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you have a great, had a great New Year's Eve, and I hope you have a great 2021. So if you like this video, please leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments. Or if you have something nice to say, please leave that in the comments. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, yeah, please subscribe to my channel. And I'll provide you with more content in the future. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.